On the phone with the head coach in the Metiti Longhorns, Zeb Hagan. And coach, first of all, thanks so much for taking some time to visit with me. You guys get to the state championship game. I guess I'm going to start with, first of all, how do you think your team has improved and progressed throughout this 2020 season to reach this point?
I think they've done a great job taking it a game at a time, and we've definitely played some tough teams along the way, but battled and found ways to win them. But it's been nice to see just every week when we watch film and after each game and see all the improvement. So kids did a good job of having that be a goal of getting better every week, and they've done that.
Talk a little bit about Dace Bennett and kind of what he means as a guy that maybe spearheads your attack more than anything.
You know, Dace has done a great job being a good leader for us. He's kind of two-way player. I mean, he's passed as well, and he's effective with the run game for us too. So, yeah, very, very important part for us offensively. High energy. And, you know, I think our team just feeds off of it. And yeah, he's been a great, great part of our success this year.
What about Hadley Abar and Calvin Erickson, two guys that really lead you defensively? What are you seeing out of those two guys?
You know, I mean, they're all over the field all the time. It doesn't matter if it's away from them and 20 yards down the field, they're going to be around the play. And it's that kind of energy, I think, that it given them the success they've had defensively for us. Hadley, you know, he's undersized, but very strong. He's able to shed blocks and make good tackles for us. And you know, he's a great blocker for us on offense too. And Calvin just kind of has a nose for the football. He's caused a lot of turnovers for us on defense, and then offensively, he's been a big weapon in our passing game.
Well, let's talk about the rematch for the championship. You guys saw Farsini not that long ago. Week 7 of the season, ended up losing that game after it was kind of close early on. So what do you look at when you see Farson Eden?
Man, they're a great team. You know, they got some great depth. I think they're well coached, and they got good leadership. They're a tough team, and they got a good tradition, too, of winning there. But I think our kids are looking forward to it. I think we were able to have some, you know, some good matches with them in that last game. And I think we're all excited just to kind of to battle it out one more time, just to find out who it's going to be at the end. So,
yeah, I was going to ask you, how nice is it that you actually have seen and played, so you guys know and have a sense of the type of style of play that they'll throw at you?
Yeah, it is nice. You get more out of that than just watching a film. So hopefully we can make some adjustments that we need to, and these kids can get mentally prepared for them, and I think they will be.
You mentioned the key word there, adjustments. So what are some of your keys, without giving away your game plan on Saturday afternoon, what are some of your keys that things have to go right for you guys to have success Saturday?
I think we just need to stick together. I mean, turnovers are always, I think it's probably one of the biggest factors in any game you play. So, mm-hmm. I mean, I think if we can, you know, limit our turnovers and hopefully get a couple on them, I think we can be in good shape. As long as we're giving our offense more opportunities to score, I think we'll be in good shape.
With that, I appreciate your time, Coach Hagan. Best of luck against Farson Eden on Saturday.
All right, thank you very much.
Now we get a chance to chat with the head coach of the Farson Eden Pronghorns. That's Tripp Applequist, whose squad gets a chance to host the Class 1A six-man state championship game Saturday afternoon in Farson Eden. And, Coach, well, first of all, you guys are 10-0 on the season, and you get a chance to host this title game. So, what do you say about your squad and what they've done to get you to this point?
You know, we've got a big group of seniors who've shown a lot of leadership and just have really worked hard all season and brought along the rest of the team with them. And so we have a really hard-working team, and we've been fortunate along the way.
As you've seen this season go along, where have you been, I guess, pleased the most in terms of progress and improvement from your squad?
I think the main thing is just people are learning their positions and really know what their assignments are and what they need to do on every play. And that's where I think we excel the most and where we've seen the most improvement.
You guys got tested quite a bit down to the wire last week against Encampment. What did your team show you by coming back in that game?
Oh, that was a close game. That one was a lot of fun. You know, at the time it's stressful, but those kids really, they just kept kept fighting all along, and they never really looked down or dropped their heads. They just kept playing. In fact, at one point during the third quarter, one of my players just looked at me and said, "Don't worry, coach, we got this." And that's really the kind of attitude they've just had, is that we're going to work hard and good things will come.
Tristan Lamori, and maybe I'm not saying his last name correctly, but he really seems to kind of be your trigger guy on offense. What have you seen out of him this season?
Yeah, Tristan Lamori, he runs the ball really well. He runs hard. He's got some speed. He's really been our go-to guy, but he also throws the ball really well, sees the football field. So he's been kind of that offensive spark that we've needed here.
What about defensively? It looks like Parker Clawson and Carson Jones really have been kind of a two-man wrecking crew at times.
Yeah, you know, Carson Jones plays linebacker for us, and he has a lot of tackles on the air. He's good at stuffing run plays. Parker Clawson plays a defensive back for us. He's good at finding that football and getting interceptions, knocking the ball away. And he's also good at making open field tackles if somebody should happen to get downfield a little further.
Well, it was week 6 that you played Metizzi. You guys won that game 35-16. What'd you take away from the first meeting against the Longhorns?
In six-man football, scores don't always tell the whole story. That was a hard-fought football game also, and I suspect that this one coming up will be also a hard-fought football game. That they're a good team, and we're going to have to contain their top players and play our best football in order to win.
Is this almost, Coach, a game of adjustments because you have seen each other already?
Yeah, I think so. I think we both know what we're bringing, and we'll have to make those little adjustments, and the team that's able to make those adjustments is going to come out on top.
What else do you look at in keys in a game that can be wide open like six-man can, but I know that you guys have this coaching down to a science since you've been out of here for over a decade. What else does this game kind of come down to on Saturday afternoon?
For us, the main thing is just that every player does his job and knows what he's supposed to do and can execute. So, yeah, we know what Metizzi's going to bring, and we're going to have to make adjustments along the way. But for us, the main thing is that all our players do what they're supposed to do on every play.
You guys have been kind of considered the favorite. How well do you feel your team has handled that role throughout this season?
I think they've done a good job of handling it. It's not something we've backed away from or promoted either one. It's just something that's out there, and we're fortunate enough to be in that position. So we like that we're winning football games, but, you know, it's just one game at a time all year long.
Well, now it's come down to that last game. It's the state championship. How nice will it be to be on your home turf?
That's pretty special. You know, it's nothing that's ever happened in Farson before, for sure. And who knows if that opportunity will ever happen again. But we're really excited about having the state championship game here, and we're looking forward to a hard-fought football game against Metizzi.
Coach Applequist, thank you so much for your time. Best of luck on Saturday afternoon.
Thank you very much.